Welcome to the Dealing Room, start of the new series. Ruchit Jain and Chandan Taparia with us this morning. Gentlemen, happy Dhanteras to both of you. Ruchit, let's start with you. Choppy trade on Dalal Street yesterday, slipped below 8600 for most of the day, but did manage to reclaim that and closed absolutely flat. Does that give you some hope, possibly some kind of a base building around that level? Could we see a up move going forward, or would you say that the trend remains in the negative?
Yes, firstly, good morning and wish a very happy Dhanteras and a happy Diwali to all the viewers of the Bloomberg and the entire team of Bloomberg. Well, coming on to markets, well, in yesterday's trading session, the recovery which was there in the last 1 hour, that was tremendous, and that too had came from a good support level, which was around 8550. This has led to formation of a hammer pattern, which is a trend reversal pattern, but that would be activated only if we manage to cross this yesterday's high. Now today, as SGX Nifty is indicating a negative opening, but in case if we manage to cross yesterday's high of 8625, then I think for short term this positive momentum could pick up. So I think in near term 8550 and 8700, these two becomes very crucial for the markets. 8550 being the support which you have seen the 89 EMA on the daily charts, and 8700 being the resistance, which is a falling trendline resistance of last few weeks of low top low bottom action which we have been witnessing on Nifty. So 8550 and 8700 becomes a crucial, these two levels are very crucial for the markets to decide the next directional move in near term. In case if we go below 8550, then that would be continuation of this down move which we are seeing since last few weeks. However, if after formation of this hammer pattern yesterday, if we manage to cross the highs, then positively that would be a positive sign, and then if, markets could head higher. Hence, in one can, for traders, one can keep a caveat that if yesterday's high is crossed above 8625, then one can create long positions keeping stop loss below 8550.
Right. Good morning, Chandan. Let's get you in as well. We've started, the October series has been subdued. But what do you make of the kind of setup that you are looking into, especially given the fact that FIIs have started this time with 79 to 80% long positions as opposed to 88% long positions, and the rollovers have been mostly in line?
Yes, good morning, happy Dhanteras and Diwali to you and entire viewer team of the BTVI. I wish to get the best opportunity in the market. May you and all the viewer continue to prosper with the support of all the expert and the analysts. Now talking about the new expiry, happy new expiry as well, and the happy news somewhat. Talking about the market movement, in the last series, the market was moving in a range. Overall, it was moving between 8550 to 8750, 8800 kind of levels. An interesting part is that market has been consolidating from last three series. On the last series, the Nifty closed near to 8615 kind of zone, and that was just up by around 25 points from the previous expiry. In the month of August and September, Nifty closed exactly at 8592 and 8591 level. So from last three consecutive expiry, the market is consolidating and settling near to 8600 zone, which clearly indicates that consolidation phase is witnessing in the market. But important part is that after the selling pressure of last three trading session, the index has managed to hold the support of 8550 zone. And the index has been consolidating in a range with a falling channel. If it manages to hold above 8720, 8745, then only we may see a breakout from this consolidation channel. But till the time, the range bound move may remain continue with the downside multiple support near to 8500 zone. Talking about the option data, in the next series, in the November series, we have maximum put open interest as 85 followed by 8400 strike. But fresh put writing started to happen at 8200 strike, which clearly indicates that as of now, participants are not expecting Nifty to go below 8500 zone. But if it fails to hold the same, then we may see a correction of 200, 300 points. And that's why after the 85, people are more interested to take the 8200 put. On the call side, we have maximum open interest at 89,000 followed by 8900 strike. So if I sum up the entire database with the FIIs flow, that is also missing in terms of the major momentum. Stock space action is clearly visible in the market. So as of now, till it holds above 8500 to 8550, trend may remain range bound, but the fresh leg of rally or conviction would start if it manages to hold above 8720 to 8745 levels.
Ruchit, let's talk about the Bank Nifty. Strong moves coming in yesterday on the HDFC Twins as also an ICICI Bank. But otherwise, it was a pretty weak day as far as the banking universe was concerned. Just your preference and also call on HDFC Twins and an ICICI Bank.
Within this bank Nifty, we are observing more of a stock-specific move now rather than, you know, entire index moving in a particular direction. We have seen that most of the heavyweights in the bank Nifty index comes from the private sector space. And within this space, if you observe the Axis Bank, definitely the trend has been negative with formation of low top, low bottom. But one thing is has been noticed over here that now we may see a pullback rally in Axis Bank too. Since from the highs till this yesterday's low, we have seen a five-wave corrective move. A minor correction, even if happens from current levels, that would be that won't be any major downside from here in this stock. So I think a corrective pullback rally or a bounce back should be seen in Axis Bank as well. Now coming on to ICICI Bank, well, probably this stock has been a good outperformer in the recent past. We have seen the stock recovering from its lower levels of 238 and again posting a high of 292. So this outperformance is still there in ICICI Bank, which may continue going ahead. 292 needs to be seen that that's a resistance. If that is taken out, then definitely that would be a resumption of the uptrend in the stock. Kotak Bank is looking positive from current levels. We have seen that the high top, high bottom structure is still intact in the Kotak Bank. And also in HDFC Bank, if we observe, then there we have not seen any major correction in HDFC Bank, but a consolidation phase which has been going on. So summing up, all these private sector banks somehow are not showing that a major correction or a downside momentum would be seen in very short term. And since the heavyweights of this, the index weightage comprises most of these private sector banks, I think the Nifty Bank Index has very limited downside. A high top, high bottom structure could be seen in Nifty Bank Index because their falling trendline resistance has recent or already been violated. So I think 19,200 to 19,100 would be a very crucial support range for the index, and on the high side 19,900 would be the resistance to watch out for. So in banking stocks, specifically private sector banks, I am positively biased, and the top picks in this sector would be Kotak Bank.
Chandan, let's talk stock specific then. In terms of the higher rollover candidates, we've got HPCL at a 94%, JSPL 94%, PTC also around a 93% registration of rollovers. Your views on these three?
Yes, talking about the HPCL and the PTC, PTC has been not performing from last couple of series. It is making lower top, lower bottom formation from last 6 to 7 weeks. So here we are not expecting much activity. But yes, the put writing at 70 strike might continue to hold the support. While talking about the Hindustan Petro, here trend is continuously positive. The stock is making higher tops, higher bottom formation. And this bounce back in the crude price is also supporting the broader sentiment of the stock. So we may remain positive in the counter as it is seen the rollover of 94%. We are looking for an up move to as 465 to 470. So one can remain bullish. 445 need to be a stop loss for that same. Talking about the Jindal Steel in metal counter, we are positive only on the Vedanta as of now. Jindal Steel is having a negative bias. Whenever we are witnessing the higher rollover, the stock tends to take the short position to rollover. Overall trend is negative on the medium term basis. So any bounce back is the selling opportunity or avoid for the long position. Apart from that, the stock which you have seen the built up of long position or the highest open interest like Simtex, where we are coming out with a positive sense. Simtex has made multiple base near to 79, 78. And now if it manages to hold above 87.5, then it can rally to us 95 to 97 level.
Chandan, let's talk about some of these auto names. Key auto earnings today, Eicher and Bajaj. You had some moves that we were expecting in Maruti but didn't really go through. Bajaj Auto slid sharply ahead of earnings today, and Hero Moto also, weak earnings reaction coming in on this one. What are you making of the moves in both these counters?
Yes, first talking about Bajaj Auto, an interesting part is that selective auto counters are performing in last couple of weeks or couple of days, and we are having the positive stance on TVS Motor, Maruti, and I think these stocks are likely to outperform the market, and now the way Ashok Leyland has bottomed out, it can continue to lead the rally. Talking about the Bajaj Auto, the stock has been making lower top, lower bottom, witness built up of short position as it corrected from 31.31 to 27.77 kind of level. So already it is corrected by around 400 points. So now some formation of support might be there, but as of now, let it stable. Rollover data is not much indicating about the reversal in the counter as of now. Talking about the Eicher Motor, which has seen the rollover of 78%, it witnessed a small profit booking decline, but what I feel that it may find support near to 23,800. So one can accumulate on a small decline of 500, 600 points. And again, it is potential to head to us 26,000 kind of level. So Eicher Motor would be buy on decline. Bajaj Auto, we have to look at that bottom facing formation, but remain positive on TVS Motors and Maruti for short term to long term point of view.
Positive on TVS and Maruti from the short to long term. Ruchit, talk about some of the oil and gas names. You had IOC earnings come in yesterday. ONGC and GAIL have been in focus as well. The movement around these names, and then, of course, maybe a Cain India too.
So GAIL, we have seen that, you know, after a consolidation phase, the up move has been backed by very good volumes. 400, which was the earlier resistance, that has been taken out, and after the breakout, the volumes in this counter have increased significantly. So I think the stock has now resumed its uptrend, and we may see some more positive momentum in the stock, at least up to 470, 465 levels. So I think any decline, minor decline, if it comes around 420, 425 range, that would be a good opportunity to go long in GAIL. On the lower side, 410 could be kept as a stop loss. Even ONGC so far has seen formation of higher top, higher bottom structure, but some sort of declines comes, then I think the risk reward ratio would be favorable to enter in. At current levels, the risk reward ratio is not favorable, that favorable. Even in yesterday's session, we have seen formation of a doji pattern. So I think some sort of corrective move could be there in the stock, but that would be a correction within an uptrend. So traders should look to buy this counter on dips rather than at current levels. 270 is a good support for the stock. So 6-7% correction, I think, could come in ONGC in short term, but that correction should then be used as a buying opportunity. Coming on to Cain India, well, if you observe the weekly charts, then definitely this is an impulsive up move which has started from this lower levels of 105, and impulsive upward somewhere I think should continue in near term. I'm not expecting any major correction in the stock. Any sort of declines up to 215, 212 range should be used as a buying opportunity in Cain too. So quite positively biased on GAIL from current levels also. And Cain and ONGC would be the two stocks where one should look to buy on dips of 6-7%.
Right, gentlemen, let's take a short break at this point. Asian markets mixed this morning. SGX Nifty indicating a quiet start for Indian trade today. Let's take a short break, come back with those pre-open quotes and continue our conversation with Ruchit Jain and Chandan Taparia.
Welcome back. You're watching Deal and Room. Let's continue our conversation forward with Ruchit Jain. Ruchit, a whole host of mid-cap and small-cap numbers have been reported over the evening. A pack of it together is something like the theme parks as well as the leisure-focused companies, Inox Leisure, Adlabs Entertainment, as well as Wonderla Holidays. Your view on these?
Well, Inox Leisure seem to be in a consolidation phase. Recently, last 3-4 weeks, the stock has been trading in this range of 275, 280 on the higher side and 260 on the lower side. I think this consolidation phase would continue, but some sort of, in case if 255, 260 support is breached, then some sort of correction could also coming, because trend following indicators are not that positive, which were during the uptrend, which was seen a few months earlier. So not that positively biased on Inox Leisure. Some sort of corrective move, in fact, could be seen. Hence, long traders could look to book profits if 255 support is 255 support is breached.
Chandan, let's look at some of these pharma names. Dr. Reddy's has been seeing gains for the past few sessions. Cipla and Sun Pharma also gained momentum in trade yesterday. Glenmark, we'll see an earnings reaction play out on that one. And an Aurobindo Pharma, what are you making of these names?
Yes, talking about pharma, Dr. Reddy has done well in last 3-4 trading session. It witnessed support near to 1030 zone and rallied towards 33 kind of level. It has surpassed the hurdle of 3220, 3250 kind of zone. And we have seen a significant delivery volume in the counter. So some positive strength is coming into the stock. Till it holds above 3250 zone, we are looking for target towards 3450 kind of zone. Oro Pharma has seen a small decline, but now near to multiple support. 785, 790 is multiple support for the counter, and if it manages to hold the same, it may witness a bounce back move towards 840 kind of zone. Talking about Cipla, it has witnessed multiple support near to 565. Longs are intact into the counter, so one can hold the long position or can initiate the long position with support near to 565 on a small decline. On upside, we are looking for a target to us, 610, 615 kind of level. Talking about Glenmark, we are not much comfortable in the stock because it has seen multiple hurdle near to 950 zone. Whenever it comes near to 950, 960 zone, it witnesses fresh selling pressure. So we would be positive on Dr. Reddy. Go for bottom facing in Aurobindo Pharma and Cipla, while avoid Glenmark till it doesn't get stability in the counter.
Just about a minute to go before we hit pre-open. Ruchit, if I could get a couple of reactions from you before that, the moves that we've seen in Idea, is that over for now or do you think that will continue? And also Airtel, which has been buzzing post-earnings.
I think in next few trading sessions, this would be an interesting space to watch out for. Specifically, coming on to Idea first, probably we have seen a good amount of corrective move in last 2 or 3 months. Now, the long-term charts are indicating some sort of support levels around the 74-75 zone. We have seen formation of a bullish harmonic pattern around in the range of 74 to 76, and hence some sort of pullback really could come in the stock. Even on the daily charts, we have, the parabolic SAR is now indicating a good support around 75. So, pullback really is expected in this stock up to 85 or 80. Levels in short term. One can go long at current levels, keeping stop loss below 70. But as I said, that would be just a pullback rally and not a reversal or resumption of the reversal of the trend from current levels. Now, Bharti Airtel, last two trading sessions, we've seen some good momentum picking up in the stock after giving a gap up opening. But on the higher side, still 330 would be the resistance to watch out for. Only if 330 is crossed, then some positive momentum would continue towards 340. As of now, 330 to 305 consolidation phase is expected to continue in this.
Three open trades hitting your screen over there. No real movement right now. We'll let those rates settle. Of course, pull up a Tech Mahindra. Want to see the reaction coming in on that one. Tata Steel a little positive in trade right now. Tech Mahindra seeing gains of about 3% in pre-open trade. Hero Moto, if the downtrend continues, Bajaj Auto also ahead of earnings today. What are these counters doing? Hero Moto is positive in trade today. Bajaj Auto absolutely flat. Also, some of these pharma names that we were just discussing have been on an uptrend. Dr. Reddy's, Cipla, Sun Pharma, Aurobindo, all of them. ITC, this has been buzzing, and I'll just head across to Ruchit and get a view on some of these counters also. ITC not doing much in trade right now. Pre-open on the Sensex is indicating us a gain of about 180 points, so could be a strong start over there. So these are, of course, indicative prices, and we'll let them settle a bit. For now, Pranoy, we're holding above 86.30 in trade. A couple of moves coming in on some of these earnings reactions, but otherwise, largely flat on some of the key stocks.
Well, absolutely, and a lot of mid-cap earnings deep, as you said, will also be in focus today. So the smaller names, Gokaldas Exports, Cholamandalam Investments, Sascom Communications, Precol has reported a good number, at least on the profitability front. Stock has done well off late. Precol will be in focus. Omax, Auto, Aztec Life Sciences, Cupid, DCM Shriram, Glenmark, as you said. United Spirits has reported a weakish quarter. There's Keval Kiran Industries, EPC Industries, the entire leisure and entertainment theme park pack, so be it Wonderla Holidays or AdLabs Entertainment or Inox Leisure. All of these will be in focus, but sure, we need the rates to settle for a bit. But from the weightage-wise movers, there'll be, of course, Tech Mahindra that will be in focus. Vedanta, of course, not a part of the Nifty, but it becomes important from the commodity complex standpoint. Bajaj Auto and Aisha. So a lot of focus on auto names and reaction on certain mid-cap names as well. Something like an Emami will react today. Marico is reporting today. We've had the larger earnings reportages behind us. So essentially, auto two-wheeler as well as tier 2 FMCG is what we'll be focusing on.
Just pull up the Bank Nifty also and see the moves that are coming in on the Bank Nifty, and then pull up some of those key movers. So the HDFC Twins after that, and ICICI Bank and Axis Bank. Bank Nifty absolutely flat right now. ICICI down about 1%. What about the HDFC Twins? HDFC absolutely flat. No change on an HDFC Bank either. SBI, Axis Bank seeing gains about 1%. What about an SBI? SBI also absolutely flat right now. Ruchit, I want to talk to you about some of these consumption names. ITC has been seeing gains. Nothing much happening as far as HUL is concerned. And then some of these mid-cap ones, Britannia and Emami and Marico, whose earnings are out today.
Well, Well, ITC, the stock was trading in an oversold zone, and yesterday we have seen some sort of positive momentum coming in. Some resistance is placed around 246, 247, but the way the momentum readings are giving a positive crossovers from its oversold zone, I think the stock could show a pullback, move up to 255. So one can look to go long on ITC around current levels, keeping a stop loss below 234, expecting a target around 255. Hindustan Unilever, probably I think some sort of consolidation phase could be seen. Yesterday we have seen formation of a hammer pattern, so it would be important to see whether 851 resistance is crossed or not. If we see crossover above 851, which is the high of yesterday's hammer, then some sort of pullback could also be seen in HUL. Britannia, amongst the mid-cap names, Britannia 2 is trading around its support level. If you observe this recent up move from the lower level of 2500, then I think the stock has completed a wave 3 around this recent high of 3500 3580. Now this consolidation phase is a wave 4 consolidation, after which another up move or up leg could be seen. The stock is currently trading near its previous lows and the 89 EMA on a daily charts, and hence it's a good support for the stock. So I think even Britannia could show some sort of pullback rally near term, hence one can go long at current levels, keeping a stop loss below 3140. Marico, I think if you observe the positional charts of Marico, then some sort of consolidation phase is going on in this stock. On immediate basis, I am not expecting any major directional momentum to coming in this. This 290 to 270 is the consolidation range in which last 3-4 weeks have been seen in this stock. On volumes basis, comparatively volumes have also been lower in this consolidation phase. So unless there is a breakout out of this consolidation of 270 to 290, traders can look to avoid. I think this consolidation could continue for now.
Right. Ruchit, let's go through your strategies. You have a call on M&M, NCC, as well as Lupin. Take us through these severally.
So from a short to medium term perspective, we are positive on M&M on the auto space. Recently, although the stock has corrected from high levels, but I think this correction gives a good opportunity for medium-term traders as well as investors to buy the stock at current levels. Firstly, on the weekly charts, we are observing this 89 EMA. Secondly, the entire up move which was seen in last 4 to 5 months, the stock is right now trading at 50% retracement of that entire up move. The momentum readings are in oversold zone. Hence, I think a pullback move could be seen in short term. One can go long at current levels, keep a stop loss below 1265. I'm expecting a target around 1375. And even if anyone is keeping a bit longer term perspective from 4 to 6 months, then I think the all-time high levels also could be seen in this stock around in next 6 months of time frame. NCC definitely looks quite positive. Recently, the stock has given a breakout with very good volumes. Last 2-3 trading sessions there, we have seen a pullback of this recent up move. The stock is again trading at its support level. Hence, for short-term trading perspective, one can look to go long at current levels, keeping a stop loss below 86.50 for target of 100 rupees. And the last pick is a buy call in Lupin. Well, Lupin is a stock which one if anyone wants to consider from medium to long-term perspective. On the monthly charts, the stock is trading around its supertrend support. Now if we observe a bit longer term charts, then from last 12 years on every correction, the monthly supertrend has acted as support. So if this supertrend support has acted as a good buying opportunity in last 12 years, so I think the risk reward ratio is quite favorable for this stock to go long at current levels. From short term perspective, one can go long with stop loss below 1440 for target of 1550, but I think this stock also provides a good opportunity for investors at current levels.
Fair point, Ruchit. So a whole host of stocks to watch out for there. Chandan, you also have some interesting names on your strategy list, a buy on a Gen Irrigation, while you're looking to sell Amara Raja Battery. Just run us through your list as well.
Talking about the trading calls, we are positive on the Gen Irrigation. And interesting part is that stock has seen the better rollover with the rollover activity. Roll cost is also rising, that is having a positive stance. The stock has been making higher tops, higher bottom formation. So we are looking for target of 114. One can buy with a stop loss of 102 levels. On last trading session, it has managed to hold the multiple support and spiked well. And this momentum extend. And recently it has surpassed the 100 zone, and that is also giving a positive stance to the counter. Talking about the Amara Raja Battery, where we are recommending to sell, the stock has failed to surpass the immediate hurdle of 1060 zone and started to decline by adding built up of short position. So here we are looking some profit booking to us 950. One can sell on bounce back move with the stop loss of 1030 levels.
Right. Ruchit, I want to focus on a couple of these mid-cap names. I have a JK paper on my list and consequently Bajaj Finance and Bajaj FinServ. If you have a call on three of these names.
The trend for JK paper is definitely positive. Recently, the stock has given a breakout from a flag pattern on the daily charts. So this is a continuation of pattern, and the volumes have also been higher, comparatively good in this recent up move. So I think 90 to 92 could be seen in the stock in very short term. So one can look to go long around current levels, keeping a stop loss below 82 in JK paper. Bajaj FinServ, the stock is expected to show some sort of consolidation in short term. We have not seen any major directional movement in last 2 or 3 weeks. So probably this stock, although the higher degree trend is positive, but in near term the stock may consolidate in this 3100 to 3500 and range. Hence not expecting any major upside momentum or even downside moment to coming in the stock in very short term. Bajaj, speaking about Bajaj Finance, even Bajaj Finance has been in a consolidation phase. 1180 is the resistance and 1050, 1040 is the support. So in both these stocks, Bajaj FinServ and Bajaj Finance, some consolidation could be seen for next few sessions.
Right. Ruchit, what's your view on something like an HCC, some of these infra companies? Because I want a longer term view. So we've seen such a big run up post the arbitration awards easing that is anticipated. Is the outlook significantly positive a quarter or two down the line?
Well, yes, on longer term charts, the stock has shown good positive breakout when it gave a breakout of after 24-25 levels, and a good amount of volumes were also seen on weekly and on weekly charts. HCC has been forming this a flag pattern. However, the breakout will come only above 42, and in near term I'm not expecting any major movement, but if anyone is taking a view from 2 to 3 quarters, so until this low of 32 is protected, I think one can trade with positive bias. If we give a breakout about 42, then that would be a continuation of the up move which we have recently seen. But from this space we are more positive. If we talk about 3 to 4 quarters, then we are more positive on IRB Infra at current levels. The stock on longer term charts have somewhere seen a good consolidation phase in the range of 280 to 200 in the, I think, last 2 to 3 years it has been in that range. Now in this recent up move which we saw from 205 to 265, the volumes were quite higher. And this correction, I think, provides a good opportunity to create long positions if one is taking 2 to 3 quarters, a time frame of 2 to 3 quarters. 225 is a good support for the stock, and I think if any sort of corrective move comes up to 225, 230, that would be good opportunity to create long positions. This entire 3 years of range, which is around from 265 to 205, there is a good, there is a higher probability that wave 5 would coming in next 1 or 2 quarters, and probably we would get a breakout about 265. So around 225 to 230 within this infra space, IRB infra could be bought with 2 to 3 quarters of time frame perspective.
Chandan, I want to focus on two consumption linked names, Jubilant Food, that one, and let's look at some of those gold linked stocks today. So let's look at Titan, Gitanjali, PC Jewelers, maybe some of the other gold linked names such as a Manappuram and a Muthoot Finance.
Yes, talking about the first gold company, especially on the Dhanteras day, we are quite positive on the Manappuram. Although this is known as an F&O counter, but we are continuously expecting it to give the movement of 15 to 20%. We have suggested the stock near to 50-55 zone. Already it has rallied, but still we are expecting it to rally to us 115 level. So those who are interested to trade in the gold finance company definitely can go with this stock. And obviously and definitely this can give the return of 15 to 20%. Now talking about the F&O counters in the gold and jewelry stocks, Titan is not performing. It is making lower top, lower bottom formation. So I'll prefer for the PC Jewelers for the buying opportunity. The stock has been consolidating in a range finding hurdle near to 517. But I think if it sustains above 517 today, it can rally to us 525 to 530 level. So in this space, I like PC Jewelers, and Manappuram can be taken for the investment point of view. Talking about the Jubilant Food, this stock has made a bottom near to 920 in the last month near to end of the September series. It rallied to us 1186, 1200 kind of zone. But post the result, it corrected by around 8 to 10%. Now again, if it comes near to 9.29-9.30 kind of zone, then it may find multiple support and may expect a bounce back move towards 1000 level. But medium term trend is negative. One can only hope for a bounce back move if it comes near to the support zone. So these will be the recommendation. Talking about the Gitanjali gems, that is the known FNO counter, we have seen sustained buying. An interesting part is there's just 3 to 4 days back, the stock has spiked with the trading volume, and the trading volume is also respected by the delivery volume. So Gitanjali gems also mature to the festival season. The stock has potential to head toward 85 levels.
Right. Very quickly, before we head across to pre-opening, Ruchit, in terms of metal names, Vedanta reports numbers today. JSW has seen a sequentially weak quarter. Any calls in the ferrous and non-ferrous names?
Yeah, Vedanta can continue to trade with positive bias. We have not seen any kind of reversal formation so far. Even the moving averages and the other trend following indicators such as parabolic SAR, super trend, they are all indicating a good support for this stock in this range of 190 to 200. So I don't think there would be significant downside in Vedanta. Any minor dips if comes, that probably should be used as a good buying opportunity in this stock. JSW Steel, the stock in last few days has already seen a good correction, but rather I would wait for some sort of reversal kind of formation before taking a call that it could resume its uptrend. The stock has support around 1590-1593, so some sort of correction I think could be seen in JSW Steel from current levels.
30 seconds to go before markets open for trade. Pre-open indicating that 8600 will be held on for now, although it looks to be another quiet start. It could be a flat start to the first day of a November series. We'll see how that plays out. Key earnings reactions will be in focus. So Tech Mahindra, that's the top gainer in the pre-open markets. We'll wait for those rates to come in. Eicher, Maruti, both of them doing well, as also Tata Motors. Select auto stocks are positive. All right, first trades coming in on your screen right there. 86.15 has held on, but absolutely quiet start. Okay, we are correcting now below 8600. That's where we are opening in trade. Sensex losing about 100 points right now. Tech Mahindra seeing gains of 5%. ONGC also amongst the gainers right now. Maruti, Tata Motors, Bosch, Bajaj Auto, Hero Motors. So looks to be a good day going forward for some of these auto names, although they are not seeing any big moves. The only big move really coming in at this moment is on a Tech Mahindra, up 5% in trade. From some of the weaker names, ICICI Bank correcting yet again, down by about 1.5%, did bounce back in trade yesterday but is correcting. Tata Consultancy Services down by about 1%. Asian Paints weak. Bharati Infratel also on the back foot. Gale not doing too well. HDFC seeing some correction coming in. ITC also correcting. So most of the big gainers that we saw in trade yesterday are in fact on the back foot today. But it really is a day that could belong to Tech Mahindra. That's gaining about 5%. And some of these auto stocks, Eicher ahead of earnings, up 1%. ONGC picking up momentum, that's gained 1% as well. Z Entertainment in focus as well. Earnings for one of its subsidiaries also came in yesterday. Lupin gaining momentum. Idea doing well. Axis Bank is in positive territory for now. RIL also a little quiet, but trading with a positive bias. On the whole though, markets absolutely quiet right now. Did slip below 8600, but holding on to that right now. A cut of about 0.1% coming in on the benchmarks, Pranoy.
Right, let's focus on the mid-caps as well. BEL is a major gainer, 5% higher right now. 8K Miles is up 3.8%. There's Mahindra Life Spaces, again, earnings counter, 3% higher. Caplin Point Labs continues the strong momentum. There's ENIL, which is up in trade as well. So a lot of these companies, Moil, Manganese Ore, and there's some news flow in this as well. Solar Industries is gaining in trade. Let's see how some of the other important earnings names are doing. There's Emami that reported numbers, and it has been a stable set of numbers for Emami. Segment-wise, we'll have to go through the details as well. It's just about flattish. There's Gokaldas Exports, as well as Cholamandalam Investments, and Sascan Communications, the exchange filing, came through a 20% cut in Gokaldas Exports. He was pointing out, operationally, it has been a weak quarter. Cholamandalam Finances, Sascan is down 2.4%. Precol reported a good quarter, so let's see how Precol is doing. And the profit has increased multifold this time around, 4.4% higher for Precol again. Omax Auto, Aztec Life, as well as Cupid, some of the other counters that have reported numbers, 10% lower for Omax Auto. So clearly 20% higher for Astec Life Sciences. Some of these earnings counters are really reacting, 7% higher for Cupid, DCM Shriram, as well as Hindustan Oil Exploration Company, a few of the other companies as well. DCM Shriram, mind you, has also seen a good rally over the last few sessions. HOEC is just about flattish. Inox Leisure, then Adlabs Entertainment and Wonderla Holidays have also reported numbers. Let's see how they are reacting. Down 5% for Inox Leisure, Wonderla Holidays, as well as Adlabs. So across the board, you're seeing some weakness in this pack, in these counters. Wonderla is down 2.3% as we speak. JK Paper has reported a good set of numbers. Let's pull up JK Paper and see how that is doing. 4.4% higher, so clearly resonating that. And let's see how Glenmark has done in terms of numbers as well. EPC Industries, as well as Keval Kiran as well. Glenmark is up just about 1%. EPC Industries and Keval Kiran as well reporting numbers. So these are some of the mid-caps that we are focusing on in today's session, Deep.
On the Bank Nifty, advance decline ratio of 1:1. Bank Nifty seeing cuts of about 0.5% coming in. Yes Bank is the top gainer right now, although not seeing too much of a move. PNB, Bank of Baroda, Axis, Bank of India and Canara, all of them in positive territory. ICICI Bank is the big loser. HDFC Bank also correcting. IndusInd Bank on the back foot, as also Federal Bank and an SBI. But on the whole, absolutely quiet on the index. 8600 is where we are holding on for now. Is Deepak Shenoy with us? All right, let's welcome in Deepak Shenoy, CEO of CapitalMind.in. Happy Dhanteras to you, Deepak. Your reading of the market print right now. We've been extremely range-bound for the last few days. Did see a sharp correction come in on a Tuesday. But apart from that, extremely range-bound, even for the entire October series, no real big moves coming in. Which camp would you be in right now? Do you see a new high before the end of the year, or would you say that markets are likely to remain like this till at least the Fed rate hike is out of the way?
Good morning and happy Dhanteras to all of you. I think, the markets have been range-bound. Like you said, they show signs of moving up, show signs of moving down. The two big events, the Fed hike, the US elections, there's potentially something happening in Italy as a referendum. There is more global macro that seems to be impacting fund flows than local events. Earnings have not been very good, at least in the large caps that we've been seeing. So I believe unless we have a trigger for us to kind of break that 9,000 barrier on the Nifty, we're going to have a very ordinary year. In fact, I see more trouble on the downside right now. Things could change. You might see some blockbuster results from the rest of the players. So I'll reserve my comments on that. But I think global factors, US elections, Italy, the Fed hike, and the hike that's already happening in the US 10-year yield and in LIBOR, I think these will affect Indian markets much more.
All right. Deepak, what do you have to say about certain two-wheeler names today that we'll be focusing on? There's Aisha as well as Bajaj Auto that reports their numbers. Bajaj Auto not so good, Aisha positive. What's your view?
I think Aisha is going to have a good set of numbers. They have been doing about between 35% and 65% earnings growth. So I think going from the sales numbers, they should do at least 45%, I think. Bajaj Auto should have a reasonable quarter. We've had good numbers from Hero, we've had good numbers from TVS. So I don't believe Bajaj Auto's numbers will be less than ordinary. I think some of their exposure abroad is going to get impacted a little bit, but overall I believe two-wheelers with a normal monsoon should do well in the last quarter and in the coming October to December quarter as well.
Right. Ruchit, just a call on the market direction today. Hovering around 8600, likely to be another flat day. And any trades that we should be watching out for? This is, of course, the last trading day of summer 2072. Something that you want to leave our viewers with?
For intraday perspective, I think we would see another range-bound trading session. Since I said that yesterday's high becomes an important trigger for short-term trading for intraday trading now. So I think unless this today's high of 86.25 to 86.30 range, it would be the resistance for intraday. Only if that is taken out, then we can expect some sort of positive momentum to come in. So I'm not expecting any major momentum in the index front, but I think for day trading, pharma sector could be a good space to watch out for. Lupin, Dr. Reddy, even Nifty Pharma and on the index as a whole is showing good positive momentum. So I think pharma sector and amongst this space, Dr. Reddy and Lupin could be the two stocks which could head higher for intraday perspective.
All right, let's focus on a few names and pull up certain stocks. Aztec Life is up 20%. Gokul Agro is up almost 14 to 15%. Golden Tobacco Company is seeing good gains, around 15% higher. Crest Ventures, 12 to 13%. So these are some of the smaller names that are buzzing in trade. On the losing side, there's Everon Education. It's seeing a 20% cut on right on opening. There's Gokaldas Exports, obviously that's an earnings candidate and a casualty there. Banswara Syntex is down 12%. Noida Toll is down almost 13%. The second straight day of weakness, the only asset that they have by way of which they earn tolling revenues in adverse order has come in via Allahabad High Court. And understandably, they'll apply in the Supreme Court an appeal there. There's Denora Industries, which is down 12 to 13%, as well as Nakoda, which is down 9%, and Camson, which is down around 10 to 11% at this point. Ruchit, coming back to you, as far as some counters like DCM Shriram are concerned, do you have any view there? Because that has seen some good gains off late, as also something like a BEL.
Well, DCM Shriram, although it's an uptrend, but you know, needs to be see how the follow-up momentum comes in from here on. Because on the weekly charts, there is more sort of a formation of a candlestick pattern, which the further movement of the directional movement of the stock on which depends on whether the high of that candle is crossed or low of that candle is crossed. The overall trend for the stock is positive. 240 is a good support for the stock. So unless 240 is breached, I think one can trade with positive bias in DCM Shriram from current levels.
All right, Ruchit, we'll leave it at that. Thank you for joining us this morning, and a happy Diwali to you and everyone at Angel Broking. Deepak Shenoy, coming back to you, the big news, of course, this week has been all the movement around Tata's and the back and forth between Cyrus Mistry and the board of Tata, and last evening Tata Sons also replying to that. No specifics coming in. Really, the big question, and this back and forth is likely to continue going forward, what should the retail money do right now? Some of the retail investors who have exposure to Tata's, should they stay invested or exit right now, ride out the volatility and then possibly relook once things stabilize?
I think personally that most retail investors would not really have an idea of what's going on. Nobody does. Perhaps a few institutionals might. But I don't think the operational performance of these companies, most of the Tata companies, is going to get seriously impacted because of this change. I don't think Ratan Tata or the chairman that comes in is going to come in and say, you know, cancel all the sales or cancel all the asset sales, cancel all the restructuring. There may be some small issues that happen right now. Remember that Tata Sons is not really an operational company, it's a holding company, and the chairman doesn't really give operational directions. He's more of a strategic performance person. So if any changes come, they will be in the much longer term. I think the stocks, you know, rightfully so, perhaps there's an uncertainty, so they've been beaten down a little bit. There are lots of opportunities. We own a few Tata company stocks, including Tata Chemicals and Tata Coffee. So I believe, you know, they're possibly going to continue to remain interesting because the fundamentals in those stocks hasn't changed. I would say wait until you see a change in fundamentals and then take a call. I think these knee-jerk reactions will come and go. Fund managers will be pressured to exit because of perhaps some of the institutional pressures that go on. But I wouldn't tell retail investors to, you know, jump and take a lot of action right now. It's just wait for fundamentals to respond.
Right. Deepak, since it is festive season, as Diwali that we are speaking about, what's your view on some of these paint names? Titanium dioxide possibly will now see some bit of an up move after the beneficial cooling period that we've seen and an expansion of margins as well. But Berger, Asian Paints, Kansai Nerolac, smaller peerage, your view?
Overall, I think, you know, some of the paint companies in India are the most expensive in the world. They tend to command extremely high margins as well in comparison. So I don't know whether I'd buy them at this point just from the aspect of saying they are great value. I think the growth also has been, you know, a little bit subdued. So I'd like to see the growth come in. I am not seeing a huge amount of festive interest in the paint in the markets itself, but we'll have to see how the numbers come in. Overall, because of the slowdown in real estate and construction, they are going to see some kind of you know, tapering of numbers. So I don't believe right now that it's worthwhile giving them those 40 or 50 PEs. Smaller paint companies, perhaps, who might be able to increase their margins. Yes.
Right, Deepak, before we let you go, last trading day of summer 2072, leave our viewers with some spaces that you think will do well in the new year where you would be betting on.
Yes, I think, you know, a couple of places that we really think that there will be growth in the next year, I think, will be consumer entertainment from the aspect of, you know, perhaps from the urban cinema goer crowd. We are invested in PVR. Also from urban entertainment stocks like Wonderla, where we don't have an investment but find that very interesting. There's also a bunch of things happening around chemical and certain road construction companies, which I think will benefit over the medium term. The chemical sector has largely been undervalued at the 10 to 12 PE. They're getting re-rated to the 20 to 25 PE, and they're showing growth numbers around 30%. So I think that is very interesting from an industrial recovery point of view, and I think that will be a useful theme to go around. I would be wary of the financials in the rate hike out, you know, the response that comes worldwide. So I would be a little wary of companies that have very high debt levels or need to finance ECB from abroad. So I think those are the things I'd stick with. More opportunities will come. The markets, I hope, are volatile enough to give us opportunities to buy at lower levels and perhaps see new highs in the next year.
Perhaps see new highs in the next year. That's Deepak Shenoy's perspective on the markets and some of the spaces that he likes. Deepak, appreciate you speaking to us today, and a happy Diwali to you and everyone at Capital Mind. Markets on the back foot in trade right now. Below 8600, seeing a cuts of about 0.3%. Tech Mahindra continues to be the big gainer. Tata Motors making a comeback in trade today, and Tata Steel as well. In fact, Pranoy, most of these Tata Group stocks are seeing some amount of a rebound, possibly short covering, possibly some solace from the response that Tata Sons put out last night.
Well, yes, and you know, Deep, in fact, most of these stocks corrected somewhere anywhere between 8 to 10%, and especially the tier 2 ones, so Tata Chemicals or Tata Communications for that matter, saw some bit of cooling off. So on back of a very significant cooling off that they saw, some bit of recovery that they are seeing, that possibly there can be some signs of short covering from those levels onwards, but nothing really to write home about, because these gains are anywhere ranged between 1 to 2%, and no major gains that are coming through. Tata Sponge has seen a sudden spike up, and Tata Investments is 1.2% higher. So obviously, I mean, natural to assume that after such a strong correction that we've seen over the last 2-3 sessions, some mild recovery that is coming through on some of these counters. Deep.
On that note, completely out of time on this session of The Dealing Room, but our Diwali special conversation with ace market investors coming up on the other side. Today, Siddharth Zarabi speaks with Nilesha of Kotak AMC. We'll be right back.